I'm gonna revisit my most popular and cringy video on this channel, and then I'm gonna vacuum my floor. Perhaps I should have invested my time in learning how to be a beauty guru, because apparently cosmetic videos are super popular on YouTube. So this 12 DIY cosmetics that actually work video has gotten nearly 500,000 views on this channel, and that blows me away. But today I just wanted to revisit it and tell you which things I still use and give you a few more DIY cosmetics that I'm currently using now but didn't use before. The first one is deodorant. What I was using then was a coconut oil, arrowroot powder, and baking soda concoction. It made like a paste. I don't use that anymore. Now I will either just use baking soda, I'll like just kind of tap it on my armpits, or I will use conventionally made deodorant almost always after I take a shower and shave my armpits, because baking soda burns after you shave. The second one was essential oils as perfume. I don't really use that anymore, mainly because I ran out of all my essential oils and it didn't add enough value for me to repurchase them. I really don't wear perfume that often, but we do have a few body sprays around. Every now and then I'll use those, but it's not really like a regular thing in my routine. The third and most controversial one was the baking soda toothpaste. I don't use that anymore. I was concerned with all of the comments that were saying not to use it. I also did have to have some dental work done, especially after my second pregnancy. But the biggest benefit to using it that I liked personally was how it made my teeth feel. And after I got that dental work done, we ended up getting an electric toothbrush, and that made my teeth feel exactly the same, just like glass. Very, very, very clean. So that's what I use now. Next was mouthwash. I actually completely forgot about this one. And very similarly to the perfume, when I ran out of the peppermint essential oil that I mixed with the water and the baking soda, I just didn't purchase any. It probably wasn't in the budget, and then I forgot about it. But I loved that stuff, and I am buying more peppermint essential oil to mix with water and baking soda because I love how that stuff made my mouth feel. All right, the shampoo and conditioner combo that I used. I probably used that for another year, but what I noticed as my hair got longer was that my hair consistency just was not nice. I didn't like how it made my hair feel, and it was really the ends. I have much longer hair now, it is down to my waist, and so I'm using store-bought shampoos and conditioners. I made a video yesterday about my makeup, so you know I don't use the same foundation I was using in the previous video. As I've gotten older, I guess I've just decided that I want to cover up more of my flaws on the outside, and conventionally made store-bought foundation helps me do that. Body wash was the next one, and I just used the baking soda and water combo recipe that I had mentioned for the shampoo as body wash. I don't do that anymore either. I use a Dial antibacterial soap. I don't know what it is about the makeup of my body, but it creates real funky smells real fast, and so once I switched to an antibacterial bar soap, it made a big difference. I'm sorry, that's just how it is. So yes, Dial antibacterial bar soap is what I use now for body wash. I had mentioned that as a face wash, I'll also use baking soda. I pretty exclusively use coconut oil now. I spread it along my face first, and then my brows and eyelashes last, and that gets makeup off of my face and moisturizes, and I really, really like that. I don't use honey to wash my face anymore because the coconut oil is doing the trick, but I do recommend trying it to see if it's something that you like. And the third face wash I mentioned in that video was the coconut oil. As you know, I still use that. I mentioned that I use coconut oil as lotion. Yes, I absolutely still do that. I do not use those homemade baby wipes anymore, mainly because we don't have kids in diapers. I do have a few more DIY cosmetics that I currently use that I'm going to share with you now. First off is the coconut oil. Two things I do with this. One is an overnight hair mask. I will just put it in my hair until it gets really greasy and gross, put it up in a bun and sleep in it overnight, and then wash it the next morning, and it makes my hair really soft. I also use it for skin irritation. I did this after I had my babies, and then I used it on my babies, and I still do. If there are rashes or different skin irritations showing up that I know aren't something else, I'll use coconut oil on it, and it's just really soothing to the skin. This right here is Poopery Spray. I bought it for the bottle because I have been mixing water with fragrance oils or essential oils ever since I discovered Poopery. You spray it in your toilet, before people go to the bathroom and then it doesn't stink as bad. And this is totally a DIY you can do and save a lot of money. I fill it up 90% of the way and then add like 40 or 50 drops of whatever fragrance oil or essential oil you want. And then you just shake it up and spray it like 4 or 5 times in the toilet and then it does its job. And the last thing I'm using is a DIY dry shampoo. It's actually very similar to the foundation I had mentioned in the previous video. This is cornstarch and cocoa powder. I put this in my hair the night before, usually just with my fingers, and it kind of helps absorb some of the sebum oil and my hair doesn't look as gross the next morning. Thank you all so much for watching. Follow me on Instagram, subscribe to my channel, give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you next time. All it needs is a little cap sitting on it. Those videos are the best.